Targeting of the governor is a worrisome trend of Boko Haram / Islamic State West Africa Province, ISWAP. It can only be described as a result on the part of Boko Haram / ISWAP to desperate measures to remain relevant in northern Borno. It is unfortunate that the terrorists, who have lost practically all their camps to the anti-terrorism operations of the Nigerian military, are attempting to make their last stand using Governor Zulum's convos as probe. There are other possibilities we are looking at as well, because there have been two of such attacks in the last 1 month, with the one last Friday, through the governor was not in a convoy, being the deadliest, and another one on Sunday, which was successfully repaired. Knowing that the governor has adequate security cover from the military and other security agencies, we can only conclude that Boko Haram / ISWAP terrorists have gone full chemicals, because their game is up. Nigerians would have noticed that Boko Haram / ISWAP was really in the news in recent months. When the terrorists do make the news, it is often reports of them taking punishment from the Nigerian military. Boko Haram commanders are being blown sky high with bombs. With bombs dropped from fighter jets on their camps. The destruction being visited on the terrorist camp is so severe that it has reportedly worsened the infighting among them, while their wounded have overwhelmed their mess kit treatment centers, are spreading disease, infections among others. This is a development that has made the financiers and supporters of Boko Haram Act of Terrorism to have begun reevaluating their continuous expenditure on the group. These financiers are reportedly told the terrorist leaders that they will cut off further funding unless their fighters can demonstrate that they are still able to inflict disturbing damage. The new fund penchant of the terrorists for targeting Governor Zulum is apparently a desperate attempt to satisfy these financiers by making a high-profile score. This is likely why they targeted the late Colonel Dahiru Bako and troops under his command, in the hope of creating the impression that they are still able to strike high-value persons. In addition to this obsession with the state governor, Boko Haram resort to increased use of improvised explosive devices, IEDs, especially on bad roads, to attack troops and innocent citizens is another of the new tactics they adopted toward that they are still relevant. We call on Governor Zulum to review the protocols for his movement in northern Borno, since desperation of the terrorists is such that they could attempt a lone wolf attack with person-borne IED. It would be a great disservice to Borno State and Nigeria as a whole if he should come in harm's way from these sociopaths.